somebody had to push me outside of my box. Which one of these are you? Are you inside the box or are you outside the box?
I know quite a few people on my reservation that have asthma.
Okay, that's east. That's north.
The air was a huge problem. The dust, the smoke.
We are experiencing weather conditions the likes of which we've never experienced in our lifetime.
Crews working around the clock to get a handle on some of the largest fires in state history.
The fires also creating thick smoke, so hazardous, it's like smoking 400 cigarettes a day.
Okay, so that's how you send your pictures to Globe Observer. So are we looking at the air coming from up here into the sensor, or do we need it to be taller where we can get more air from the surrounding? That's the thing that you ladies are going to have to figure out. Do we want it to be this?
This project that we're working on is working with air sensors. We plant them wherever, and we figure out if the air is good enough for people with breathing problems.
The air will flow into here. Here are the sensors. I feel like this could help my reservation. People with respiratory breathing problems, asthma, and of course my elders.
So once you put this in the ground, my question is, will anybody have the capability of knowing what the air quality is in Mescalero?
Yes, they could.
This little box is what Shiloh and Caydence will be using. The 3D part that's being printed, this box will mount onto it and be able to set on the tabletop, and they should be able to see all the readings on the air quality sensor. My idea of a Globe teacher is a teacher that, number one, is concerned about the environment. Number two, concerned enough to allow the students to dabble into different projects and see if it's something they can connect with. Growing up, I hated school. You would have never believed that I would turn into an educator.
Right here.
Right there.
My favorite part about the project is coding. Actually, here in the school, they're learning how to code in the Mescalero Apache language, and I find that pretty cool.
The color of one.
We don't want our language to die out like other reservations. I know a lot of reservations don't know their language because some elders are gone that knew a lot about their language, and then the kids don't like know how to learn it. So I feel like it's really important to keep our language alive.
All right, right here, I think it'll be. I like to have fun with my students. Now I want you just to hit this, not my hand. I don't have any qualms in telling my students how I grew up, because some of them are facing what I faced when I was in high school. This is our map. And if you look at that gray dot there, that's Mescalero Apache School. And there's our reading. And it takes data every 10 minutes. Okay, every 10 minutes, it's going to report some kind of data. What I want these kids to realize is more to life than just living on the reservation. Somebody had to push me outside of my box, and that's what I do. I draw a box on the board, and I put dots inside the box, a whole bunch of dots, and maybe one or two dots outside. I said, which one of these are you? Are you inside the box or are you outside the box? The person outside the box got more opportunity because he or she is not confined. to the inside of that box.
I see myself going to college for engineering.
I do want to go out. I do want to leave my reservation, learn new things, travel.
I want to be recognized on my reservation and around the world. That's my goal, is to like succeed in front of people who thought I couldn't do it.
And I tell these kids all the time, I say, you know what? You may not see it, but I do. I see what you're capable of doing, and I'm not going to push you where I know you can't go. But if I'm pushing you, then I'm telling you, you can do this.